You see, what happens is that when you speak the word, and Jesus is the word of God, it becomes part of your soul. It bubbles up. It becomes part of your DNA. And that's part of what we're going to do to learn how to be a blessing to others and to receive blessings, is that we have to speak positive words to ourselves. We have to go to the scripture and go to the Bible and really have that just fill us. Now, there are three steps involved in receiving God's blessings in an optimal way. The first, we'll look at Luke 11, 9 to 13. And if you have not brought your Bible, you can write the scriptures down and look at it later. In Luke 11, 9 to 13, we learn the principles of asking for God's blessings. Ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. Now, we've heard that so many times, but how are we to ask? How are we to ask? Well, my favorite beatitude is, blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled, satisfied. Think about this for a second. Hungering for God. Think about yourself starving. Think about yourself in a desert, not having a morsel of food. Think about how thirsty you are. You're crawling on your hands and knees. You see an oasis out there. You see the water out there. Think about that. That's how much we're to ask Him for a blessing. That's how much we're to seek Him. Seeking Him, we will find Him. Knock and the door will be open. Now, here's a very, very important point. Only in Luke, because this is in all three of the synoptic gospels, but only in Luke does it say, in verse 13, how much more will the Father in heaven give the, what? Say it louder. Holy Spirit to those who ask Him. So we're going to ask today for the Holy Spirit to come down upon us. Are you ready for that? Heavenly Father, we ask the Holy Spirit to come upon all of my brothers and sisters here, to be anointed with the power of a new Pentecost, a new fire, to be filled with the Holy Spirit. And you said, Father, ask anything in your name, especially when we ask for the Holy Spirit, and it shall be done. In the name of Jesus, we pray and thank you. Amen. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord God. Hallelujah. So the Holy Spirit, what does it say in Acts 1:8? When you receive the Holy Spirit, you will receive power. Power. And the word power in Greek is translated to dynamite. Dynamite. You will receive dynamite. And then you will be my witnesses. And then you will go forth and be my disciples. You will be my witnesses to the ends of the earth. How many people want to be the Lord's witnesses? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. You see, it's God's desire that you be blessed. That's God's desire that you be holy. It's God's desire that you be His witnesses. But first, we have to ask for it. We have to ask for it without any reservations. Now, what prevents us from asking it? What prevents us is sin. You see, because when we're leading a sinful life, we choose other things other than the Lord. We think other things are going to give us comfort, but they don't. They're just temporary. Or it may be some other things in our life that might happen. It might be a lack of faith. But usually it's between lack of faith, lack of wanting to do our own thing, I want to do it my way, or it could be shame. You see, the devil's great tool is to convict us in our minds that we're unworthy. I'll tell you a little story. It's a true story of a man who was in a parish, who was devoted to his wife for 60 years. Was active in his parish, was part of that great organization, Knights of Columbus. He was a man who was blessed, that everyone held on great esteem. He was dying, and a priest came to him and saw this look of horror on his face. And he asked the man, he said, "What's wrong?" And the man said, "I have a sin, unconfessed sin." And this is a true story. And the priest said, thinking that he killed somebody, thinking that was something really major, he said, well, during the Depression, we were hungry and we had no food, and I stole an orange, and I never confessed it. He had carried that with him. You see, that's what happens. What happens, whether we've stolen an orange or whether we've done something that we're not proud of, the devil wants to use that against us. But Jesus is Lord, and he died for our sins because we are righteous not because of what we've done, but we're righteous because of Jesus' death and resurrection. Amen?
Amen.
So all we have to do is turn to that, to Satan, turn to that whisper and say, I am a child of God. In fact, repeat that now. I am a child of God. I have washed clean through the precious blood of Jesus. I have been washed clean through the precious blood of Jesus. Give the Lord a hand. By the way, how many here are new to the Charismatic Renewal? Raise your hand. Okay, great, 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 great. Well, you're seeing what the Charismatic Renewal is about. You may not see this often in your churches as often as we'd like to say, but we get excited about the Lord, right? And that's, is that great? Is that a blessing? Well, let's continue. So we know that the first step is asking for the blessing. The second step is really believing in our heart that we've received the blessing, right? So we get rid of the unworthiness. We open up the God's love and God's blessing into our hearts. But the final step is being transformed by it, transformed by the blessing. And here again, we're going to go to Scripture. And we're going to go to Ephesians 1. And by the way, this is called a Catholic Bible. This is our Bible. The Protestants are borrowing it. This was created in the very beginning. Catholic, it is Catholic, okay? So this is something that is so important for us and so important to have this part of our life. We're going to look at Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavens. How many?
Every.
Not one? Not if we're just good? Not if we never sinned? Everyone? And how many spiritual blessings are there? I'm calling on you. How many spiritual blessings are there? How many stars are there in the sky? That's how much your God, our God, loves you. He has blessed you with every spiritual blessing. Please stand. By the way, this is Catholic, so we do calisthenics, we stand, we sit, we do all these things. Okay, so what we're going to do, because this is a very important part of receiving God's blessings, this is extremely important, is that we put our names in the middle of that scripture, because that scripture is meant for you personally. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to say, I, and give your name, so I, Steve, have received every spiritual blessings in the heavens. So let's all repeat it now. I, give your name, have received every spiritual blessing in the heavens. Now, I'm not sure you totally believe it, so we're going to do it again. Only this time, we're really going to yell out the word every. Okay? So, ready? I have received every spiritual blessings in the heaven. Let's give the Lord a hand for that. Amen. Please sit. Well, if that's not enough, he said he chose us before the foundation of the world. Now, isn't that interesting? Before the foundation of the world. You see, when we die, we go back to Jesus, back to the Father. He knew us. He knew us. He knew us before we were born, as it says in Scripture. He knew us. He has carved us in the palm of our hands. He loves us so much, we have been chosen. And how have we been chosen? How have we been chosen? To be what? Anybody know the scripture? To be holy and without blemish. Is that unbelievable? Now let's say it all together. I am holy and without blemish.